Every week I do an opening statement on whatever it is that has me fired up. This week, take a look. The GDP under Obama was barely one. We're going up to four. So you want to talk about hate crime?
I'll tell you about
fought
a metric.
For a but law for hate crime.
I also think it's important, as we said, 89% of the Republican Party still supports him. He still has huge popularity in the country. And if Democrats don't get their you-know-what together, he's certainly going
well,
to get reelected.
Here's my question for you. Here's my question for you because
Trump
you talk about you talk about.
I am not, Judge.
Nobody
is.
Did you just point at me?
Yes.
Listen, I don't have Trump derangement. Let me tell you what I have.
Okay.
I have a lot of, I'm tired of people starting a conversation with Mexicans or liars and rapists. I'm tired of people starting a conversation about this country. Listen, I'm 62 years old. There have been a lot of people in office that I didn't agree with, but I have never, ever seen anything like this. I've never seen anybody whip up such hate. I've never seen anybody be so dismissive. And clearly you don't watch the show, so you don't know that I don't suffer from that. What I suffer from is the inability to figure out how to fix this. That's my issue. But one of the things that you talk about a lot, and I'm curious about it, is the deep state. How long has the deep state been there, and who's running it?
Well, I want to answer your question because you gave
your
opening statement, which was how horrible it is that Donald Trump is talking about all of these people.
You know what? That's what you said. You said
people shouldn't be here. End up murdering the children of American citizens.
You know what's horrible?
What's horrible when
the president of the United States whips up people to beat the hell out of people.
No,
say goodbye.
After that, I was cursed at, and I and my team were thrown out of the building. Should I be angry? I suppose I should. But in the end, this isn't about me. And nobody needs to feel sorry for me. I'm a big girl, and I'd go back on The View again. No one intimidates me. But more on this issue, specifically to Whoopi, who I've known for years later in the show. As I said, this isn't about me. There's a bigger issue at play here. The View is just a microcosm of what's going on in this country. The level of hatred toward the 45th president of the United States is beyond anything we've seen in American history. He was once an icon, sought after for movies, television, by politicians on both sides of the aisle, sports figures, and yes, even the media. Then he ran for president. Now Donald Trump is the target of vitriol so palpable, it's simply frightening, and reason has become irrelevant. We can't have conversations anymore, and the ripple is national in scope. Family, friends, acquaintances can't even talk to each other. They remove each other from Facebook, and they change dinner and family gathering plans for the holidays depending on their politics. It's almost impossible to have a rational discussion that doesn't turn into a food fight. And for some, it's now even fashionable to threaten the president of the United States.
He talks how he wants to punch people in the face. Well, I'd like to punch him in the face.
They asked me, would I like to debate this gentleman? And I said, no. I said, if we were in high school, I'd take him behind the gym and beat the hell out of him.
When was the last time an actor assassinated a president?
Yes, I have thought an awful lot about blowing up the White House.
And that's not all. When a member of Congress can say this about people who work for and support the president, we have a real problem in America.
You have members of your cabinet that have been booed out of restaurants. Who have protesters taking up at their house, who saying no peace, no sleep. And if you see anybody from that cabinet in a restaurant, in a department store, at a gasoline station, you get out and you create a crowd. And you push back on them. And you tell them they're not welcome anymore, anywhere.
Not welcome anymore, anywhere. The anger of the left in America is out of control. when White House Press Secretary Sarah Sanders needs Secret Service protection because she speaks for the President of the United States, something's wrong. When we get screamed at even before we give an opinion, something's wrong. When it's acceptable to shout people down, when it's acceptable to not hear what people think, that's the first step to where we don't think. And thinking you're right and not allowing debate is fascism, whether it comes from a Democrat or a Republican, or the right or the left, it's wrong. It seems in America today that the takedown of a president is more important than the success of our nation. I lived through 8 years of Barack Obama. A lot of you heard my opens. I was very clear in my objection to his policies, but I never rooted for America to fail. The things that we should all want and that no one would be against simply don't matter anymore. Minority unemployment, the lowest in history, the economy soaring, ISIS defeated, tax cuts for everyone. They don't seem to matter if it's under this president. Some people are even rooting for an economic collapse.
Is like, I feel like the bottom has to fall out at some point. And by the way, I'm hoping for it because I think one way you get rid of Trump is a crashing economy. Yeah. So please bring on the recession. Yeah. Sorry if that hurts people, but it's either root for a recession or you lose your democracy.
So to all you on the left who are threatening our president, shouting down and even attacking his supporters and rooting against America, you're kidding yourselves if you think that what you're doing is standing up for America. What you're doing is tearing down America. And when you do, you're tearing down something more important than even the President of the United States. You're tearing down the values of the United States itself. Everyone has the right to speak. But when you can't even listen to what someone has to say because you despise the man who is president, you undermine not the President of the United States, you undermine the United States.